Hey guys, so today we are in a quick drive also. I am going to see a soccer match from my kid in Sintra. And as we are going to do some highway, I will test the self-drive modes and I will let you guys see it by yourself how the car handles the situation. So I positioned the cameras in a different way so that you can see also my wheel drive and also the street from the other camera. So let's see. I don't know when the GPS is going to put me on the highway, but I know that we are going to do some highway today. So this is 20-minute drive, 24 kilometers. So we are going to do some urban first, and then we will get in the highway for the final kilometers. And then we will reach Sintra. And unfortunately, I will not be able to show you the beautiful village of Sintra because the field for the soccer match is immediately in the beginning while we enter in Sintra, so we are not going to go inside in regard to Sintra, but one day I will go do a quick trip there so that you guys can see the beautiful village of Sintra. So today is the 1st of May, it's an holiday here in Portugal. I believe it most of Europe it's holiday. So we have some special people on the streets today, so it's like Sunday. So we need to be more careful. Turn right.
In 700 meters, turn left.
So we are still in urban. Today it's a very nice day, so 22 degrees. The weather is clear. So it is still not as hot as usually it is in Portugal for this time of the year, but it is already very good weather.
600 meters, turn left toward Cascais.
So I will do a couple of tests on the highway. So I will start with 100 kilometers per hour to see if there is any slowdown or if there is any issue. And then I will increase to 110 to see if then the car changes the behavior doing the turns. So if it does any slowdowns or not. Okay, guys? I will do then a proper video just focusing on that, analyzing in the exact same route in the highway. I will do it at 100 and then 110 and 120 to see if there are differences in the exact same turns with the car, so that we can even in fact compare the situation. But we will do these tests.
Take the exit.
Also today. So we are getting in the highway right now. From the people that didn't saw the live that I made at the end of April, I am now currently driving on eco mode, okay, because I found that it gives me enough power to do my normal routes. I usually just change to standard if I am in a city driving and where sometimes I need to be a little bit more aggressive or have more reaction in the accelerator. But for most of these routes that I usually do, eco is more than enough. It gives me plenty of power to take over any other car. As you can see, the car just handles very well, so it is very fast, so no problems at all with eco mode. For another toll, so we have more tolls than we have roads. It's always paying, paying, paying. this small route. I will activate now the self-driving, okay? So activating now, and we are in self-driving, so I will reduce the speed to 100. Let me just move to the right lane as soon as we have here the possibility to move. So I will move now to 100, okay, speed. I will move now to the next lane so that we keep on the right lane because we are at 100 and we are in self-drive mode, full self-drive mode. Sometimes I need to put my hand on the wheel because the car will complain if I'm not doing that, but the car is now completely in self-drive. It can make the lane changes by itself, as you saw before, and we will keep doing this. So as you saw here, it gives me the alert that I need to push a little bit the so again, we are at 100 kilometers per hour. It is a highway of 120, the speed limit, so we are well below the speed limit. Let's see this turn if it slows down. So it is slowing down, see? So 90 on this route. I need to change here my lane because we will need to keep on this one, so I did had to push it a little bit. But as you saw, it did slow down even at 100, okay? So we are still at 100, it's moving by itself. So as you saw, I was able to take control of the self-drive system, and then as soon as I let the wheel and the accelerator back again to the car, he resumes the speed driving, so we don't need to reactivate it. So it is doing by itself. Let's see now another turn. I do believe that usually it has more difficulty to do the left turns, so it did reduce a little bit to 99, but okay, no worries. Sometimes it goes to 101, but see, oh, okay, but now it's different. Okay, there was a car coming to my lane, and that's why it has that the ACC, the adaptive cruise control, so it did control a little bit this separation with the car. But let's see with 100 if it does slow down a little bit or more. We still have 2.7 kilometers to go, but it's just for a toll, and then we will do 110 to see if there is any change. So as you can see now, it is performing well. So at 100, it's doing it without any issue. Now it's a left turn. Let's see again if it is going to. So again, it's reducing a little bit. Sometimes I also think that he gets scared about the other cars that are moving or getting through us. Let's see now this right turn. It's a very small one. And now this left again. So let's see if it slows down a little bit here or not. 100. Still 100, and now we are in the turn. Okay, it did okay. So I will terminate now because I need to go through the toll here, another toll. And then we will activate at 110, okay? Let me just go to this lane here, and now I will activate again. Activate it. Let me just change to 110, and here we are. So now 110 on a 120 speed limit highway, and let's see how it performs. Well, now it's straight, so no big test here. We will have a left turn there, so let's see how it handles. But my worry is that we have a car in front of us, so let's see if the car at least stays. is braking, the car is braking. Oh man. Now I don't know if it is because of the car. I think it's because of the car that is in front of us. So the car, of course, our car, it's reducing the speed because of the car that is in front of us, so we are not able to test it. Let me just move my lane here so that we can start taking over the car. So we did it. We are still in a curve, a turn, and I will go back there. We are still at 110, so more traffic here now. We are not going to be able to test it because there is a bunch of traffic and the car will be slowing down because of the cars in front of us, so it's going to be difficult to test this situation. But this is how self-driving with an XPeng feels like. So we can make these automatic line changes. The car controls the speed of the car based on the cars in front of us, even independently of the speed that we set up. But it does it well, as you can see, no big issues. So now the cars in front of us are braking, so of course we are braking also, and that's it. We are almost leaving the highway, so I will stop this so that we can reach the exit here. We are entering in Sintra. Right now we are going to enter in Sintra. It's probably a lot of traffic here because when the weather is good, many people come here to this village. So that's it, guys. I think that we can close the video now, because the idea was just to make a quick trip with you guys and check and test a little bit the self-driving and lane change while driving, so that you have a quick view on how it feels. So thank you very much again. I hope you like this content, this type of content. I will be doing more trips, more rides with the car, so that you just feel how driving an XPeng feels like. Leave a comment if you want me to do some different type of trip or anything that you would like to see me doing with the car. And I will see you in the next one. Okay, bye bye, guys.